Writing in a column in the Times, Mr. Ferguson warned that Mrs. Merkel's decision, which he claimed was made after a young Palestinian refugee had broken down in tears in front of her, may come back to haunt her as she struggles to form a viable coalition government. The historian described the German Chancellor's policy U-turn as the single biggest error in the history of the post-war German Republic, Mr. Ferguson said, faced with Reem Sahwil's tears. The Chancellor's reaction was an impulsive attempt to comfort her, followed by a massive unilateral U-turn, which she later had to reverse. Since the start of 2015, the number of people seeking asylum in Germany has risen sharply, with the country having received 1.38 million initial applications. Of this figure, a third of whom are Syrians, three quarters are aged 30 or under, and 60% are male. And Mr. Ferguson warned the mother of Europe could have made the mother of all mistakes in her attempts to appeal to the left and please her conservative party. Mr. Ferguson said, the political backlash has only just begun, but already it has transformed the German political landscape. In last year's election, the anti-immigration party Neues Alternative for Germany came third with 12.6% of the vote. The latest polls have it on 15% and rising. Getty Angela Merkel may pay a price for her error over asylum seekers, says historian Niall Ferguson. Merkel's fans like to call her Mooty Mummy. Well, this was the Mooty of all political blunders. Historian Professor Niall Ferguson. Merkel's fans like to call her Mooty Mummy. Well, this was the Mooty of all political blunders. Mrs. Merkel, who leads the Christian Democratic Union CDU party, is currently trying to cling to power by forming a coalition government with the Socialist Democratic Party SPD, currently led by acting chairman Olaf Scholz, following the resignation of Martin Schulz earlier this month. The deal is yet to be ratified by the SPD's rank-and-file members, and Mr. Ferguson said there were no guarantees that it would be. Writing for The Times, Mr. Ferguson, the SPD's decision depends on a postal vote of all 463,000 members between February 20 and March 2. Getter Professor Niall Ferguson believes Germans may punish Mrs. Merkel for her decision. Getter asylum seeker Reem Sahwil famously cried in front of Mrs. Merkel in 2015. Conventional wisdom says she scrapes through, but more than 24,000 new members have joined the SPD since the beginning of this year. It's reminiscent of what happened to Labour when an influx of new members strengthened the hand of Jeremy Corbyn against the parliamentary party. Even if the SPD does sign up for another coalition, the deal states that the parties will review it after 2 years. If the SPD says no, she forms a minority government. That too would be short-lived, I think.